Chemistry can feel like a whole new language, especially when a lot of the questions you will see are word problems. It's important to be able to translate word problems. Let's go over the common words that relate to math operations, starting with addition. Some keywords and phrases that mean addition are combines with, the sum, increased by, plus, the total of, or even just the word and can all refer to addition. Moving on to subtraction. These keywords and phrases are the difference of, minus, decreased by, subtracted from, less than, reduced by, and so on. Next is multiplication. The keywords and phrases here are the product of, times. You could even just see the word of, and that is your hint that this is referring to multiplication. As for division, some keywords and phrases include the ratio of or the quotient of. Let's not forget about the words that refer to an equal sign and, in some questions, the arrow in a chemical equation. These words are form, produce, create, yield, and result. Of course, every chemistry topic has its own keywords or terms to know. So let's go over some of the most common word problems in chemistry. Starting with writing a balanced chemical equation from just words. Here are some keywords to know. There are four states you will see in a chemical equation: aqueous, liquid, solid, and a gas. When a question says dissolved, dissociated, ionized, or even just aqueous, this is how you know the state of the compound or element is aqueous, which we label as AQ and place this in parentheses. Liquids are pretty easy to figure out since it's typically water, or the question will mention that there is liquid. We can't always assume that water is a liquid because it could exist as a solid or a gas. If a word problem states a precipitate or metal, then this is a solid. For a gas, the keywords are vapor, gaseous, or any of these diatomic molecules. Note, diatomic molecules are elements that exist in pairs. These are our diatomic molecules. Next, in a balanced chemical equation, it is important to know what your reactants and your products are. The keywords for your reactants are these: reacts with or combines with. The keywords for your products are these: forms, yields, creates, results in, converts into, or the most common one is produces. Also, note that your reactants are on the left side of the arrow, while the products are on the right side of the arrow. And the last part of this is knowing your types of chemical reactions. Some keywords here are decomposes, which relates to a decomposition reaction, which looks like this, where a compound is being broken down to multiple products. The word rust can hint that this is a single replacement reaction, which looks like this, where one single element replaces another element in a compound to form a new compound plus an element. Combusts or burns tells us this is a combustion reaction, which looks like this, where the only thing that changes is this reactant. But the O2 is always your reactant, and your products are always carbon dioxide and water. If you see the keyword of precipitate, then you know it is a precipitation reaction, which looks like this, where your reactants are aqueous and one solid is formed. The solid is your precipitate. Let's translate this word problem into a balanced chemical equation. Note, for this video, I'm not going to get into how to balance chemical equations, just how to translate them, and I won't go over how to name compounds, but I will have the links to my videos that do cover this in the description. This question states, gaseous propane C3H8 burns in oxygen gas to produce carbon dioxide gas and liquid water. Start with identifying the keywords. The word gaseous tells us C3H8 is a gas. Next, the key word here is burns. Burns tells us the type of chemical reaction. This is a combustion reaction, so it will look like this. So we know our reactants are C3H8 in its gas state, and oxygen gas refers to O2 again in its gas state. Next, the word produce tells us that our products are carbon dioxide gas and liquid water, and this is what our balanced chemical equation would look like. Here's another example. It states, mercury 2 oxide in its metal state decomposes to produce liquid mercury and oxygen. Start with identifying the keywords. The word decomposes tells us this is a decomposition reaction, which looks like this. So we know that the only reactant we will have is mercury 2 oxide in its solid state, which looks like this. Next, the word produce tells us that these are products. The mercury is in its liquid state, and remember that oxygen is a type of diatomic molecule, meaning it will not just look like this, instead it exists in pairs. So this is O2 and it is a gas. This is our balanced chemical equation. I'm going to teach you how to utilize and translate the word of in several chemistry word problems. You'll find these problems in topics like dilutions and molarity. Let's start with questions on dilutions. You will see a volume in liters or milliliters, the word of, and molarity represented by a capital M. Molarity refers to the concentration of a solution. In a dilution question, we use this formula where the M represents molarity and we have two different molarities, M1 and M2, while the V represents volume. We have two different volumes, V1 and V2. We could also use this formula where C refers to concentration, which is still measured in molarity. Sometimes you might not be sure what value in the word problem is M1 or V2, and if you label anything incorrectly, you could get the answer wrong. For these next examples, I will be showing you how to figure out how to label what you are given. I won't be solving the question. Let's say you were asked to find the volume in milliliters that you should dilute 51 milliliters of a 10 molar nitric acid solution to get a 0.1 molar nitric acid solution. First of all, we know this is a dilution question because our keyword is dilute. So we will be using this formula. Next, label which values are M1, V1, M2, and V2. The word of tells you to keep these two together, meaning these are your initial molarity and volume. So this other molarity has to be our M2 and we are solving for V2. Remember that the word of often refers to multiplication, which is exactly what happens here. In the formula, we are multiplying these two numbers together. Same concept applies to a molarity question, specifically solution stoichiometry. It will be really helpful to know what volume goes with what solution. So again, use the word of to help you figure it out. This question gives us 34 milliliters of H2SO4. So we know to keep these together when setting up our question. We are also given 27 milliliters of a 0.1 molar NaOH solution. This means that the 27 milliliters are of NaOH and the molarity of NaOH is 0.10. Lastly, we are asked to find the molarity of the H2SO4 solution. Just by knowing what value belongs to which solution will really help you solve a question like this. It helps you be able to identify what you are given and what the question is asking you to find. Keep that momentum going and practice. I've made plenty of practice problems for you over on my website, melissa.help/practice. There you can master this topic and then come back to learn from the next video in this playlist.